So you want the gold knife, but you're struggling with this, this, and maybe even this. Well, struggle no more. My name is Mizmi, and I'm going to show you how to do every single knife camo challenge in the quickest, most efficient way possible. In order to start completing the camo challenges, though, you're going to need to level that knife all the way up to 30. So let's start with how to get there nice and fast. So our good old friend Zombies is going to be the quickest way to level the knife up. It took me about 90 minutes with double weapon XP on, and I am far from an expert at zombies. So if you're an absolute beast at zombies, you can probably get it done quicker. Being able to level the knife up from 1 to 30 in such a quick time is so good, and I would highly recommend it. However, don't feel like you have to do zombies to level the knife up. If you're like me and you start getting bored after maybe half an hour or a couple of rounds of zombies, feel free to just take a break and start working on some of the early challenges that you've unlocked already, because there's no better feeling than making some progression with the knife. But again, if you can stick it out, just get the knife to level 30, unlock all those challenges, and then hop into multiplayer. So once you've got the knife leveled up, or you just can't wait any longer to jump into multiplayer and start progressing those challenges, you're going to need a good class to do it with. So let's head over to Create a Class and I'll talk you through it. I'll see you there. This is the class we're going to be using to get these camo challenges done. We'll ignore the primary, we're not going to be using that. We'll ignore the knife too, because there's no attachments, so don't worry about that. Onto the tactical, we use smoke grenades. These are really good for breaking lines of sight and closing the gap on your enemies. You can also hide inside of them, and when enemies try and push through, you just stab them. It's pretty simple stuff. I find smoke grenades are by far the best for general knifing use. Let me just put it this way, in comparison to a stun or a flash, you throw them, they explode, they're done, that's it. If you hit an enemy, you've then got a time limit to get to them and actually stab them whilst they're still under effect of it. But with smoke grenades, you throw them, they explode, they stay there for absolutely ages, and during that whole time, they're benefiting you, which is why I think smokes are by far the best tactical to be using when you're trying to knife people. On the lethal, we've got tomahawks. They're just for a bit of flair. Who doesn't love chucking those tomahawks, bouncing them off walls, chucking them across the map? I certainly do. You can use whatever you want here though, but you know, bit of flair, everyone loves it. Build upgrade, I originally started running with the SAM turret, just because we don't have ghost on this class, so putting that down to passively shoot down those spy planes I thought was a good idea, but at the end of the day, I just end up with the field mic. It's just really strong knowing where your enemies are, so you can position yourself on a corner ready to stab them as soon as they come around. In terms of the perks, we've got flak jacket in perk 1. Explosives are absolutely everywhere in multiplayer, so having flak jacket on is absolutely key. You can run tactical mask if you choose to use stuns or flashes, and we do use them for some of the camo challenges, so I'll get to that later. Perk 2, I recommend using tracker to start with whilst you're getting used to the playstyle of the knife. It really helps track down enemies, know where they've gone when they've run through or out of your smoke. Once you're an expert at knifing, put Gearhead on. I lied. Put Quartermaster on. This perk lets you recharge your equipment over 25 seconds. I'm sure you can all read. And this is incredible because once you're getting better with the knife and you're staying alive longer, you're managing to get a bit of a streak going every now and then. Having those extra smoke grenades is amazing for being able to continue moving around the map, sneaking up on your enemies, and just staying alive and carrying on getting those kills. So whenever you feel ready, put Quartermaster on, but maybe start with Tracker. And for perk 3, I think Ninja is a no-brainer here. Yes, Ghost is nice. But when you're trying to run around behind people, if you've got Ghost on and you're making elephant footsteps behind them, they're just going to turn around and kill you. So if you've got Ninja on and you're running around behind enemies, they're much less likely to turn around. Unless you get unlucky and they check the minimap, but chances are Ninja is going to be better than Ghost in most situations. And of course, danger close, we get an extra smoke grenade and an extra tomahawk. Who doesn't want that? One extra bonus tip whilst we're here on how to get even more equipment is to learn where all the resupply crates are in every single map. These completely refill all of your smokes, flashes, stuns, tomahawks, whatever, and your ammo, obviously. And once you've used one, there is then a 1 minute cooldown before you can use it again in the same life. However, if you die, that cooldown is set to 0 and you can use it immediately in that new life if you need to. That is everything you need to know about leveling the knife and the class setup before you get into these camo challenges. So, let's talk about them. Unlocked at level 1 are the spray challenges. These simply are to kill enemies. 75 is the highest amount you need. You really don't need to worry about this challenge because it will happen by the time you're done with the other ones. So we'll move on to the next one. Stripes, which are unlocked at level 5. Now these are to get 25 backstabber medals in total. Again, the general playstyle with the knife is sneaking up on enemies, so you're going to be getting a lot of these backstabbers, and only needing 25 in total is not too bad. So again, this challenge is likely to be done by the time you finish the other harder challenges. Unlocked at level 10 are the classic skins. Now these are execute 25 finishing moves on enemies in multiplayer. This is the first really quite hard challenge to do, but you are able to give it 100% of your focus and smash through this challenge in no time. And I'll show you how. So by far, combined arms is the best place for getting this challenge done. The strategy that you'll follow, and you can see it in the footage, is sneaking up behind enemy snipers or assault rifle players and executing them. Simple as that. And if you don't know how, in order to execute a finishing move, all you have to do is hold down your melee button when you're behind an enemy. The best map I found for this challenge is Miami when you're playing combined arms. There's so many flank routes and there's so many obvious spots that the snipers sit. It's an absolute heaven for getting this challenge done. I literally got this challenge done in 3 games. It was insane. I went on a 9 kill streak of assassinating enemies. And if you want to see that footage, then head over to my RNG Camo Mastery series. That is basically my Road to Dark Matter series, but I'm unlocking the gold guns in an order decided by a random number generator. It's great fun. Feel free to go check it out. I'll put a link above and in the description below. It'd be great to see you there. Moving on to the next challenge, it's geometric time. It's kill 50 enemies whilst injured in multiplayer. Now, this challenge is by a mile the hardest one to get done on the knife. It's an absolute nightmare, but luckily, I'm here to help. So the first key thing to know about this challenge is, in order to get progress towards it, you must kill an enemy whilst you're on 50 or less HP. You have 150 max HP. That means your health bar has to be equal to or less than 1/3. And you'll know you're getting progress towards this challenge because you will get the Survivor Medal. As you can see, this has to be done on low life, and 50 or less meets this criteria. Now, in terms of getting this challenge done and really focusing on it, because it was the last one I had to get done, and it was a real brain teaser trying to figure out how to actually do it on purpose. The strategy I used is to put on Flak Jacket, which you probably already have on, put Semtexes on instead of Tomahawks now, and it sounds ridiculous, but you just grenade the floor, make sure you're below 30% HP, and then you run in and hope you find enemies and you stab them before your health starts regenerating. That's what I did, it worked for me. It's relatively consistent, or at least as consistent as it can be. Another example that 100% works, at least at the time of recording this video, is done in Fireteam Dirty Bomb. So this time, in order to do this, you bring Molotovs, you down an enemy, or as many as you want, with your knife. You then throw a Molotov on the floor, stand in it for a little bit. As soon as your HP is less than that 30% crucial mark, you then finish the downed enemy with your knife, and you will get a Survivor Medal. It does count towards your challenge. I have tested it rigorously before recording this video, just to be 100% certain that it does work. Another way of doing this, which I have tested, but because I don't know if it actually progresses the challenge or not, I can't 100% say it worked. But if you down an enemy with a chosen primary weapon, and then stand in a Molotov again, and then stab them to finish them whilst they're down, it does come up with a knife kill in the kill feed, and it does give you a Survivor Medal. But whether it counts to the challenge or not, that's something you guys might just have to test, because obviously I've done the challenge already, so I can't see any progress going up on it. But I'm pretty sure it works. If not, let me know and I'll make a post to update you guys. So by using either or both of those two methods, hopefully you'll be able to get this hardest challenge on the knife done nice and easily, no problem. Moving on to the next challenge, which is Flora. This is unlocked at level 20, and this is get 50 kills while sliding in multiplayer. You will know you've got a sliding kill on an enemy when the low blow medal appears. This challenge is a bit ridiculous. You've just got to be running around the map and sliding every time you're trying to kill an enemy. It's kind of a slow challenge, but it's not insane because at least you have some control over it. So really the only advice I can give for this challenge is just try and slide for every single kill that you do until this challenge is done, and hopefully it won't take you too long. One method I did try and use to actually force this challenge to be done is to down an enemy in Fireteam Dirty Bomb with a primary or my knife, and then whilst they were downed, I would try and get a sliding kill on them, but that does not work. It 100% does not work. I've tried it, so don't try that. I was quite disappointed when it didn't, but at least we know it doesn't work. And the next challenge, coming in at level 25, is killing 50 enemies disoriented by your smokes, flashes, or stun grenades in multiplayer. So this challenge is quite a pain, but like I said before, if you're using smokes and you're trying to get the other challenges done, you'll probably get this one done most of the way. That's at least what happened for me. But if you do need to focus on getting this challenge done, literally the best way to do it is you throw smokes down in high traffic areas, such as like the middle of Nuketown or one of the garages in Nuketown or inside the houses, and you just sit in it and enemies will come through, and you will get this challenge done reasonably quickly if it's the last one you've got to focus on to clean up the challenge to get it gold. Another tip for forcing this challenge through is basically the same as the assassinations. Go up behind enemy snipers, preferably in combined arms, is where you're gonna have the most luck. And instead of assassinating them this time, you simply just chuck a flash at them or a stun. Make sure you've got tactical mask on, by the way, and just stab them whilst they're disoriented. And that's what I did to finish up the last remaining few on this challenge. You could potentially combine this challenge with the assassination challenge and flash them and then assassinate them, but I feel like the kill animation on a takedown is maybe a bit too long, so you might run out of time of them actually being flashed for this challenge to go through. Maybe give it a go, but I would try and keep those challenges separate from each other just to ensure you're getting this one done nice and quickly. And finally, unlocked at level 30 is the double kills challenge. This is one of my favorite ones to get done pretty much on any gun, because it's basically saying, hey look, go absolutely ham, try as hard as you can, kill everyone you see. There's no special tactics to this other than what I've already said of using smokes to close down the gap and just the general knife play style. Getting this challenge done is pretty fun and it's not too difficult, so don't worry too much about it. You will get it done reasonably easy, especially if you're focusing on other challenges. This one will just kind of happen as you're going along, and in no time at all your camo list will look like mine. Everything done, gold will be unlocked, I've even got diamond. I've done the grenade launcher as part of the RNG Camo Mastery series. So as a quick heads up, I will be doing a diamond grenade launcher and knife tutorial at some point in the coming weeks. So make sure that you subscribe and turn notifications on so you can see exactly when that video goes live and get these weapons in the special category diamond. It looks pretty fancy, not gonna lie. But for now, we're sticking with the humble gold knife. It looks lovely. In game, it's absolutely beautiful. So hopefully this guide helps you out, helps you get this knife done nice and quickly. And I would like to pre-congratulate you on your gold knife. Good job for sticking through it. I'm sure there were some ups and downs, but well done. Anyway, my work is done here. I hope you enjoyed the video and I'll see you in the next one.